Welcome to Style Woodbridge. I'm your host, Samantha Roth, and today we're at Woodbridge Center for the third annual Woodbridge Food Truck Festival. I'm very excited to meet these vendors and try some of their most popular items. With 30 food trucks, there's something for everyone. So let's go eat! Thank you so much for taking the time to talk to us.
Sure, thanks for coming over to see us.
So tell me a little bit about what you're serving up today.
We have pretty traditional barbecue fare. We have ribs, pulled pork, chicken, brisket, baked beans, coleslaw, cornbread, and mac and cheese.
Awesome. And so what is your big hitter? Like, what's the thing that everyone always orders?
I'd have to say our ribs. Our brisket's a close second. We cook with New Jersey hickory that we grow on our own property, and we rub them with our own rub that we've created. And we smoke them for about 4 to 5 hours until they're, you know, 190, 200 in internal temperature. Then we finish them off on a grill. And then we serve everything dry, so you add your own sauce afterwards if you want it.
So what are you gonna make for us today?
Well, we're gonna make some ribs, and then we're gonna do a caboodle, which is our plate that has pretty much everything we have to offer in it.
Very cool. Well, let's get in that truck and start cooking. Brisket for the first time, and while I stuff my face, why don't you tell them how they can find you?
Sure. So check us out on Facebook, butchessmackyourlipsbbq.com, and our Instagram is butchesbbq, B-U-T-C-H-E-S-B-B-Q. We try and post at least a week out where we're going to be for that following week.
Okay. So mac and cheese, I'm kind of a critic here. Cheddar?
It's good, yeah, cheddar. There's a bunch of cheeses, but yeah, cheddar's one.
It's very dynamic.
Yeah.
There's a bunch of cheeses in there. All right, she's not messing around, guys. Find her. Make sure you stop and check out Butch's Barbecue this summer. I'm here now with Jean Mandolina of Mandolina's Cheesecake. Thanks for stopping and taking the time to talk to us. Tell me a little bit about what you guys do here.
We are doing frozen chocolate-covered cheesecake on a stick. We also do apple pie a la mode. Cheesecake cannolis and iced tea, limeade, and iced coffee.
Interesting.
Yeah, we got some good sweets. Good sweets.
So how did you guys come up with this frozen cheesecake situation?
We've been making cheesecakes in Hunterdon County since 1982, before I was born. My mom and dad started the company. And my mom had the idea one day, not one day, actually she, somebody wanted a cheesecake lollipops for their wedding. And she got the idea from that. So one day we went out with a little tent set up, and then we kind of started building these trailers, and we've been doing it ever since for about the last 6 years now.
That's a smart bride. I mean, cheesecake lollipops, way better than cake pops, yeah, in my opinion. So what are your most popular items?
I mean, the cheesecake cookie sandwich that we make is phenomenal. It's a graham cracker chocolate chip cookie piped with our cheesecake, the cheesecake on a stick dipped in chocolate. And, you know, our cheesecake filled cannoli. Those are our top three, I think.
Fantastic. And what are you going to dip for me today?
I don't know. What's your favorite topping?
And these
we got all these to choose from. So anything you want, we can put on it that we have.
I think we're going to go Oreo cookie crumb.
All right, cool. We can do that. That's a good choice, yes.
All right, let's do it.
All right.
This is so good. While I stuff my face, tell them how we can find you guys.
You guys can find us on Facebook, Instagram, our website, madalinascheesecake.com. Yelp, you know, all the normal ways people are looking up people online nowadays. So
awesome. We'll definitely find you cheesecake on a stick. That's a great idea. Now we're at the Lab food truck, and I'm with the Doc.
Hello.
Doc, hi. Tell me about what you guys are serving up here.
So we're basically Asian barbecue and fusion. The motto is we're braising the streets, so we braise all our foods. Nothing is cooked on the truck. Everything's already coming hot. But the difference is, like, a lot of people don't use short. We use short rib as our beef.
Right.
You know what I mean? People are not going to use short rib. It's an expensive cut. We take the risk of doing it. Pork belly, it's another expensive cut. But we feel different, like, than other taco trucks when we go to events, because they just got the regular chicken,
yeah,
the regular beef, and we're nothing like that. Everybody thinks we're a Spanish one, but it's more of an Asian barbecue. If you really look at the menu and read the different ingredients, it's all Asian.
Very cool. So what are you going to make me today?
Today I'm going to make you a short rib taco, a braised in sweet chili. It comes with cilantro, ginger, coleslaw. Then it has scallion aioli. We're the only place, I bet you, that you'll ever find scallion aioli. It's made out of scallions.
So wow.
Sauce made out of scallions. The only place you'll probably ever find that has that. And see how you guys like that today.
Fantastic. They're not messing around here at the Lab. That's a lot of ingredients we're throwing on these tacos. Let's get in that truck. Here, why don't you tell the folks how we can find you guys this summer?
This summer, you guys can follow us on the Lab Food Truck, laboratorycatering.com, or Lab Food Truck on Instagram, or Laboratory Catering on Facebook. We post all our events. We're usually in the Union County area. We do hit a lot of local events. We also have a restaurant in Kenilworth on 18 South Michigan Avenue in Kenilworth. We're right there, located on the corner. We're open basically every day of the week, but Monday is the only day we're closed. Pretty much open to about 9 o'clock each night. And you can check us out any time of the week.
Awesome.
We'll always be around.
Well, these tacos are really, really good. What is this? That's a cabbage in there, or what?
Yeah, it's cabbage, carrots. We use a nice olive oil and cilantro ginger mix into it.
Awesome.
And it gives it a nice crunch when you bite into it, right?
Yeah, no, a very good crunch. It brings out this different flavor. Like you said, it's a Thai fusion. That's very apparent when you bite into that. It's a very different taco, and I'm excited to finish these guys up. Thank you so much, Doc. I'm here now with Jed, and we are at the Rolling Dough Wood Fire Food Truck. Jed, this is a cool concept. Tell me a little bit about how you get the wood fire oven here in a truck.
Well, it's pretty cool. We actually have an antique horse trailer, which is right behind, as you can see. And the oven actually folds out like a transformer when we get to the job. So it's inside the trailer during travel. Then when we get to the event, we roll it out. There's a platform, and then we light the fire, and we're good to cook pizza.
Very cool. And what is the point of wood fire? People say that all the time, like, oh, it's wood fire pizza. Why is that special? What's different?
The pizza has a totally unique taste. It's more of the temperature even than the wood. When the pizza cooks at such a high temperature, it gets charred, and it's a much different texture and flavor than you get from any other oven.
Very cool. And what are some of your most popular pizzas? I see you have a couple of different options for us here today. What's the big hitter?
It's pretty funny. Our vodka is our best-selling pie, the vodka pie by far. And then you're going to find this probably, you're not going to believe me, but when we go to places like Hoboken and Montclair, our vegan pie actually a huge hit. So we actually have a vegan pie. So, and and obviously our margarita is a huge seller everywhere as well.
Right.
So that's a staple.
Very cool. Well, what are you going to make for me today?
Whatever you want. We could do, you want to do a margarita?
Yeah, let's do a margarita. awesome. Ooh, look at that pesto. That's nice. That's very nice. All right, Jed, let me know. What's your social media? How can we find you this summer?
You can find us, our biggest social media is on Facebook. It's Pie Oh My. And then our Instagram is Pie Oh My NJ.
This is so good. Right. And you can never find... It's such a different type of food truck to have. There's a lot of trucks here today, but I think the diversity is really, really cool. So thank you so much, Jed.
You're welcome. Thank you.
And our last stop for the festival is the Torta truck. I'm here with Svetlana, who is the owner of this truck. Thank you for pulling yourself away to talk to me. Tell me a little bit about what you're serving up here.
So we're serving up tortas. The whole concept came out as to we usually see taco trucks and quesadillas and burritos, and I feel like not a lot of people know what tortas are, so we want to show that tortas are just as great as tacos and quesadillas and burritos. And what tortas are, pretty much, they're authentic Mexican sandwiches. They're pretty hefty. We layer refried beans, lettuce, tomato, Mexican cheese, and usually some form of protein. For today on our menu, we have al pastor, which is another popular Mexican item. It's usually pork meat that gets marinated in pineapple and Mexican spices. It's not spicy, but it's very flavorful.
Yes. Very cool. So what is your most popular item that people order all the time?
Definitely al pastor or our fiesta fries. And you can have the al pastor in either a torta form or tacos.
And your fiesta fries, I saw that on the menu. Tell us what are fiesta fries.
So there are loaded fries with a Mexican twist to it. We have a layer of French fries with Mexican chorizo, salsa verde, sour cream to help balance it out. We drizzle Mexican cheese on top and a sunny side egg on top.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Put an egg on anything and I'm in.
Yes.
So good. So what are you going to make for us today?
I kind of wanted to make both for you. I wanted you to try the al pastor and the fiesta fries because you kind of have to.
I have a little more room left. So I guess if I have to eat more, I'll just, you know.
Yeah, you
it's my
to.
Job.
Yes, you have to.
All right, awesome. Let's get in that truck.
Okay.
Tell me what we have here.
So here we have two tortas al pastor. One is with jalapenos, it's on the spicier side. And then one is with salsa verde, it's more on the mild side. And then we have our fiesta fries with the sunny side egg on top.
Fantastic. Okay, so I'm gonna try the more mild torta because I like jalapenos, but I just...
Yeah, these are definitely on the spicy side. Definitely on the spicy side.
Okay, great. So while I do that, while I eat, tell the people your Instagram, your Facebook, all the different ways we can find you this summer.
Yes. Okay, so you're going to follow us on Torta Truck. We have a list of events coming up all throughout New Jersey this summer. So just follow us and you'll be able to see where we will be out in the summer.
Okay. My first torta.
Yay! You officially have eaten your torta today. Yes, you have.
Oh, wow. The roll is very good.
Yes, which is important.
Yes, it is. And that's pork, you said, right?
Yep, pork.
So good, so
and
good.
Mexican string cheese.
Oh, yeah, that's the white cheese in
yes,
there, right?
Yes, it is, yeah.
Very good. Mm-hmm. All right, well, thank you so much. This was awesome.
My pleasure. Hope you enjoy.
And just like that, another Woodbridge Food Truck Festival comes to an end. Thank you so much for joining us on this episode. And thank you to all the vendors who fed me today. I don't think I'm gonna have to eat for a week. Until next time, I'm Samantha Roth. Thanks for watching.